Something that might be of interest to you is a program called PhotoScore. The developer is called Neurotron. And to my understanding, Finality has done away with scanning entirely from within the program. I wonder if that has to do with the fact that Peaksware now has Alfred Publishing and Make Music joined the hip, perhaps. And they're a little bit paranoid about the copying, the piracy potential there. But there is PhotoScore for Sibelius. So if you only have a PDF or a printout that you want to turn into a PDF, that program is optical character recognition. You can scan a, you know, something that was done in Finality or another program and bring it into Sibelius with, you know, a little bit of tweaking. I can't show it to you again because I don't have it set up on this system. But what I did do is I took a piece of music that I had written. I'm not even going to, like, you know, get really into the score right now at all. It's a piece of music that I did. I think I did this with the second band, Jeff, the Samba for My Father a few years ago. So this has that Finality-like look to it because, yes, I did it in Finality. But I wanted to show you guys what happens when you import a file, or bring it into Sibelius. It's much better not to use an export MIDI. It's much smarter to use export XML. XML stands for Extensible Markup Language. And what that does is by exporting in this XML format is it preserves a lot of the details that otherwise would have been lost in the chart. If you export a MIDI file or .mid, you're going to lose, you know, the dynamics, you're going to lose a lot of the expression text, you're going to lose a lot. But what you can do is you can create this kind of a file or an XML file, and it's really just a bunch of text as you see there, but I can just take this and I can bring it into Sibelius. It just takes a few seconds for Sibelius to translate this. It can take a while to generate the XML file. In the case of this piece, I think it took 4 minutes, which doesn't seem like that long, but kind of does seem a little bit, right? Go grab a cup of coffee. All right, so I'll say something. There's a couple things that are a little glitchy here. It doesn't matter what fonts I select here in Sibelius. By the way, who uses Sibelius here, just so I know? A show of hands. Okay, great, so several of you. So I'm going to say fine, you know, just let the defaults do their thing. I'm going to say okay. And bear in mind that this was exported directly from Finality, I think 2012 is the version that I have. Like I said, it's an older version. Now, there's a couple funny things that happen right off the bat here. You guys remember the name of the tune? It was Samba for My Father. So at some point, the tune must have been called Happy Samba. I have no recollection of that whatsoever. But as you can see, you know, pretty good, pretty good. The only sort of gray area for us is has to do with the fact that the fonts are kind of funny. I mean, this looks like Broadway font or something here for the instrument names. And then down at the bottom, yeah, not so much, okay? That's where Finality would have been referring to what they call staff styles in Finality language. Have you had that presentation yet, the Finality one?
No.
Okay.
2 weeks.
Okay, great. So, you know, if you use Finality, one of the really cool things about Finality is that you can just select a huge swath using the mass edit tool and then push like S for slash notation. It just generates a ton of slashes for you. So Sibelius didn't really know what to do with that. You know, everything else opens up pretty nicely. You know, and if I did want to take care of those, the font-related issues, this is super handy, by the way. In a way, you're blessed if you didn't use Sibelius 6 or earlier, because they made so many changes going from 6 to 7 for so many of us. I started on like Sibelius 1.4, I think, and then they came out with Sibelius 7, and it was like, whoa, big changes. But that ribbon is new as of Sibelius 7. And I think it's a good thing, because honestly, for me, sometimes it's faster just to start typing stuff in here than it would be for me to have to go and find it manually. So I'm just going to go edit all fonts, and then here I am, and it's going to point me, obviously, to the appropriate place to launch that command. So let's go ahead and do that, and I took note of some fonts that seem to work pretty well with this, so I'm going to go for the main text font here. I'm just going to start typing in the first few characters, and it says Plantin MT Standard, and then I'm going to go under main music font. And for this one, it's going to be Ink Pen 2 Standard. And for music text font, I selected Opus. Okay, and wow, that actually starts to look like the chart that we were looking at in Finality, right? And it'll play back to you just the same way. So, not perfect, you know, and I'm not showing transpose here, but it's not that bad. Like I said, I just threw it through Export XML. Not trying to get you guys hooked on going one way or the other, but if you had to go to Sibelius for a project and you use Finality, don't forget about the XML, the Extensible Markup Language option. Also, your Finale person, you were probably used to using Speedy Entry. Okay, there's also Simple Entry, and there's Hyperscribe. Hyperscribe is sort of like real time, it's more like sequencing almost. And Simple Entry, I've seen some people do incredibly well, but I think most people use Finale use Speedy Entry. And or you can emulate that Speedy Entry by coming in here to the preferences, in case you missed that. There's the Sibelius preferences, and then it's note input. And then here's the deal. So Sibelius' sort of default behavior is, I call it lock and load sometimes. You know, you pick the duration and then you start entering the pitches. But what always happens, like people who use Finale, it's like you want to be able to play some ideas and then commit to having them. Any Finale people know what I'm talking about? So I always end up telling people, well, hit the escape key in Sibelius, that'll take care of that problem. But if you forget to hit the escape key, the next best thing to do is just to set this to pitch before duration. And I want you to notice one more thing while I do that, is down here, you'll notice that it says to enter a quarter note, or crotchet type, okay, is 4 on the keypad. It's inverted in Sibelius and Finale, okay? So in Sibelius, we've got half note assigned to keypad 5, and then in Finale, of course, it's quarter note. So if I go like this, pitch before duration, you'll notice if you look at the keypad, keep an eye on that keypad in the lower right-hand corner, you can see how that just flipped around, okay? So again, I'm not trying to get anybody to switch here, but if you ever have to do any work in Sibelius, these are some things that are really gonna help you out.